Greetings, Ventures. This is Lorne, your guild advisor, back with some more DanMemo news. And we finally got that collaboration event announced. I know, I think it was last week or so, I said that we should just stop thinking about the collab because it will come when it comes. And sure enough, the following week, it came. And it's a collaboration between Goblin Slayer and DanMachi. Now, Goblin Slayer being the collaboration, this was something I predicted before the Data Live collab was a thing. I thought the Goblin Slayer was a high probability before we got the Data Live collab way back in March, because Goblin Slayer is actually under the same light novel publisher as DanMachi. So I thought it was a very high possibility that Goblin Slayer could be the collab back when Data Live was the new one. But I guess we just got it here right now, because Goblin's Crown, which is the Goblin Slayer movie that adapts Volume 5 of the Goblin Slayer light novel, will be premiering in Japan very early February. I think it's on the 1st. And we'll actually get a new character that you probably haven't seen from the actual anime series if you're just an anime only. And she is the Noble Fencer, who you can see here in the art on the top left. And she will also be a free character during this event. So it's really cool, especially for fans of Goblin Slayer, if you like that, because I think it does blend in very well with the fantasy setting of DanMachi. Of course, Goblin Slayer is more of a dark fantasy than DanMachi is, which is more lighthearted. But as DanMachi has been getting deeper and deeper into the light novels themselves, it's becoming more and more darker as Belle becomes more and more mature. And because we're probably going post-season 2 with how this event is structured for Belle, he should be level 3, so he should be a more experienced adventurer than past collaboration events. So hopefully he is on equal terms to Goblin Slayer, but judging from the PV, which I will link, it seems that Goblin Slayer saves Belle, at least judging from the PV itself. But you can see a ton of characters in this art. You see Priestess, the new Noble Fencer, High Elf Archer, Cowgirl, and then the Sword Maiden, and of course Belle and Goblin Slayer himself. And I did mention the light novels earlier, but of course the scenario in this event is co-written by the author DanMachi Fujinomori-sensei and the author of Goblin Slayer, Kumo Kagyu. So look forward to how they integrate the characters into the story and bring them together for something fun, because I think the most recent event, a collab, which was Data Live, was really well done. So I think Omori is only getting more and more experience working with other authors, and they should be able to make something pretty special with the scenario during this collab. And this will actually be a two-part event that lasts from January 30th all the way to February 26th. So I'm not sure if we're just skipping Valentine's altogether. If we are skipping Valentine's, we might be actually getting a White Day event, which would mean more male Valentine characters, which would be appreciated because we've had a few straight years of Valentine girl units. So White Day male units, to bring it on. But anyway, back to the collaboration event. Here is part one, titled Dungeon and Goblins. In this, if you complete quest 1-2 on normal, you'll be able to get a free 4-star Goblin Slayer. And he's actually one of the characters on the gacha banners. So you'll get one copy from doing the quest here. And then, as you can see right here, play the long tail to receive a 4-star Silver Venture Goblin Slayer. He's also on the gacha. And then the second ad is clear quest and get a 4-star Lightning Clash Noble Fencer. She is the new character in Volume 5, and she'll also have a part in the movie. So it's very interesting to see that anime onlys will be introduced to this character from the collaboration event, because I don't believe we have a date for when Western areas are getting the Goblin's Crown movie. But you will be able to max limit break the Noble Fencer for free during the event, but you won't be able to get all her bonds until part 2 of the event comes out. We don't really have a date for part 2, but I can only assume it would be 2 weeks into the event. That makes a lot of sense if they do handle it that way. Now let's quickly go over all the new units. We got a lot of skill translations, and I'd like to thank Gil Wright 6212 for all of that. Here we have Silver Adventurer Goblin Slayer. He is a dark type physical attacker, lots of strength. Very high agility as well, 1045 max limit break, max hero ascension. For his special art is a single target ultra dark physical attack that does 60% more damage for each strength buff on him, and it also will increase his strength and dark attack damage by 90% for 3 turns, so he's gonna hit pretty hard for a single target attack right there, that special art. And for his regular combat skills, his first skill is an AoE critical rate, penetration rate, physical resistance, and dark resistance debuff of minus 30% for 4 turns. So lots of debuffs going on there. It's just a debuffing move. There's no attack with it, but it's a lot of debuffs, and you could also use him in a way where you put like one of those revolving anklets on him, so he uses that move, switches out with your prime attackers or something like Record Buster or something like that. And then for his second skill, it's an AoE mid-dark physical attack with an ultra unguard rate, and it'll increase the amount of damage your opponents take from both single target attacks and AoE attacks by 20% for 4 turns. His third skill is a single target super dark physical attack with a high penetration rate and temporary strength boost, and will also increase his own strength and dark attack damage by 40% for 3 turns. So his third skill is pretty strong, because not only is it a super attack with temporary strength boost, it'll also boost his own strength and dark attack damage. It's just pretty crazy that all that is combined into one move. And of course, for his passives, it's called the Ogre Killer, but I wrote it in Goblin because, of course, I assume that the monsters in the event are going to be Ogre type, but of course they're going to be Gaborins. Next up, we have Priestess, who of course will be a healer type character. She has 15, 17 magic and max Lumen Break, max Hero Ascension. For her skills, her special arts is a single target Ultra Thunder magic attack with a temporary magic boost, and will increase your ally's strength and magic by 80% for 3 turns. So, kind of like Haruhime, except the buff is a little bit smaller, being at 80% instead of 100, but she does damage, a lot of damage, as a result of that. So, pretty much built for Record Buster, just from that special arts with the buffs, and then that single target attack. And for her regular skills, her first skill is an AoE strength and magic debuff at 35%, and also will give your allies a 35% HP regen for 3 turns. Her second skill is an ally-wide buff. It's a fast skill and will increase your special arts gauge charge gain by 33%, and will also deal low thunder magic attack damage to your opponents with ultra uncounter rate. So it's an attacking move, it's fast, and it will also increase your special arts gauge charge. So almost like Line as well. So Line and Haruhime skills kind of combine into one character, so you can do more special arts and also deal a little bit of damage to that second skill. And then for our third skill is a single target super thunder magic attack with a temporary magic boost, and will also increase the status buff turns on your allies by 2 turns, and also increase the status debuff turn duration of your opponents by 2 turns. So very much like Haruhime, increasing the turn durations on your allies' buffs and your opponents' debuffs. And then for her passive, she has counter healing, very useful, and then a passive HP and MP regen of 8%. So if she does have some costly MP skills, she will get a bit of MP back from that MP regen. Next up is the High Elf Archer, one of my more favorite characters in Goblin Slayer. She is a physical attacker, and you can see right there, her max attack will be 1911, a max Hero Ascension, max Limit Break, and she's very fast with 1041 agility. As for her special arts, it's an AoE Ultra Thunder physical attack with an Ultra Unguard rate, and will also reduce enemy physical resistance and thunder resistance by 30% for 3 turns, so very good AoE attack, especially for teams that are focused in both physical damage and thunder type damage. And as for her regular skills, her first skill is a self fast dexterity and thunder attack damage buff of 60%, and will also give your allies a dex and thunder attack damage buff a little bit less at 20%, all of that for 5 turns. So she boosts herself the most with the double 60% buffs, but she will also give your allies a smaller buff of 20% for 5 turns on each of those buffs. And then for her second skill, it's an AoE slow super thunder physical attack that will increase in damage by 60% on stunned targets, and also has an ultra penetration rate, and will also increase her strength by 60% for 3 turns. So it's a pretty interesting skill. It will only deal that extra damage if it's on stun targets, and remember that stun is an ailment that only lasts on the turn it's inflicted, so that's why the attack is a slow attack, because your opponents will be stunned during the duration of the turn. And the way with her passive, which we'll cover just right now, her passive is a 90% chance to stun the enemy upon counters. So the reason why the attack is slow for skill 2 is because you want her to go towards the end of the turn, after she has a chance to counter your opponents and possibly stun them, then deal that extra 60% damage at the very end of the turn with that second skill. And then for her third skill, it's a single target high thunder physical attack with an ultra critical rate that will increase in damage by 30% for each dexterity buff on her. So she looks like a very interesting character to use. I'm just curious to see how she works in practice when she does come out. And then next up is something pretty unexpected to me, is that Oka, of all people, not really one of the main characters of DanMachi, getting a collaboration unit, which is kind of crazy because usually you think main characters of the franchise would be getting collaboration units like Bell, Eyes, Hestia, not someone like Oka, but he does look really awesome here. He's even called Demon Slayer Samurai Oka. I know some of you guys are wanting a Demon Slayer collab, so you kind of got it with Demon Slayer Oka, but not really. He does kind of give Guts vibes, though, if you know about Berserk. But anyway, his max strength is a whopping 2002, and he has a pretty good defense of 600. And let's go ahead and look at his skills for his special arts. It's an AoE Dark Ultra Physical Attack that will increase in damage by 50% for each dexterity buff on him, and will also have a Ultra Unguard rate. As for his regular skills, his first skill is a Self, Fast, Strength, Dark Attack Damage, Guard Rate, and Counter Rate buff of 40% for 5 turns. So a lot of buffs going on right there, all to himself. I'm very curious to see how this unit works in practice. For his second skill, it's an AoE High Dark Physical Attack with a high penetration rate and temporary strength boost, and will also increase the duration of his buffs by 2 turns and heal 10% of the damage done with this move. So you only need to use his first combat skill once to get those buffs, and then just continually use the second skill and just keep adding on to the buff duration with it. And then for his third skill, it's a single target High Dark Physical Attack with an ultra critical rate and a temporary strength boost, and it will taunt. Now with this third skill having a taunt on it and also being single target, it's going to be interesting to see if people try to use that in something like War Games, because normally you would just want to use the AoE move to deal damage against all your enemies. But the taunt right there being guaranteed, you wonder if they're going to be making some kind of like boss encounter or some kind of quest where you need to taunt a singular opponent to help you with the actual quest itself. So we'll just see how they work with that. And then as part of his passive, kind of like how High Elf Archer works, she has a ailment associated with her counter. Oka has a 60% chance to taunt upon his counters. So that's probably how you'll be getting the taunt off during War Games, just relying on his counters. And then he'll be countering a lot if you use that skill right there, his first skill with a counter rate of plus 40% for 5 turns. And then next up we have the free unit Noble Fencer, so her stats probably aren't as high as other gacha type characters. She's probably going to be a balanced character, seeing that her strength is only at 1432. And then for her special art is an AoE Ultra Thunder Physical Attack with a temporary strength boost, and will also increase her own strength and thunder attack damage by 50% for 3 turns. As for her combat skills, her first skill gives your allies 20% HP regen for 4 turns, and will also increase her own strength and thunder attack damage by 25% for 4 turns. So a decent kind of buff there, and also giving your allies some survivability with the HP regen. Then for her second skill, it's an AoE Fast Low Thunder Physical Attack that will remove strength and magic buffs, including assist skills. So that second skill is actually very useful for like newer players that don't have many units that can remove strength and magic buffs, because that's used a lot in very tough boss encounters like Record Buster, where you have characters increasing their strength and magic and you want to remove those buffs so they don't do as much damage to you. Then for her third skill, it's a single target mid thunder physical attack with a high penetration rate, and will also decrease the opponent's strength and magic by 25% for 4 turns. So pretty much a character that you use if you're a newer player, because she does have a lot of utility when it comes to survivability and then just taking off strength and magic buffs. Here is Cowgirl, and one thing to note about Cowgirl is that her voice actress is someone that guest appeared on the latest live stream. Her name is Yuka Iguchi, and she actually voices Chikusa in DanMachi, who is coincidentally the other assist for this batch of characters. And she is also in charge of singing all the OP songs in DanMachi, so very interesting tidbit. But anyway, as for this assist, she has pretty balanced stats. She has a very interesting dexterity of 504, and for her skill at plus 5, it will increase the strength and magic of your allies by 15%, and will also give your allies plus 15% HP regen, so a very all-around kind of assist right there. And then, like I said, the next unit is Chigusa wearing Cowgirl's outfit, which is kind of cute because they do share the same voice actress that I said earlier. And I do think she really does look very, very cute in that outfit like that. And she is not wearing it quite the way that Cowgirl is, because Cowgirl has a little bit something that Chigusa might lack, but I do think Chigusa is cuter in the outfit because of that. And she also has pretty balanced stats, but she does have a fast speed of 528, and then her assist skill plus 5 will increase your ally's endurance, agility, and dexterity by 10%, and it also has a 80% chance to slow your opponent. So if you were running like an ailment type team in war games and you get that slow off, you're going to be having a very good day when it comes to turn priority, because it'll be going first a lot if your opponent has no ailment resistances and you're using that 80% slow. And also because she does have the plus 10% agility buff, that will help you quite a bit when it comes to speed, especially if you are lacking an agility assist. But as for how the banners are broken down, we have the Dungeon Goblins Fate Gacha. Remember, this is time limited, so all the characters will be here for only a limited time. They will disappear after the event ends, and you can only limit break them with their associated bonds or with star bonds. So for the first 4th, 7th, and 10th draws, you have a guarantee Goblin Slayer, High Elf Archer, or Chigusa. And then on the chance banner, you have Priestess, Oka, and Cowgirl. Now do remember, this is part 1 of the event. They did show Sword Maiden in the initial art for the collaboration events, so I can only assume that there will be a part 2 gacha, kind of like how the Christmas event worked. So I'm not sure if we're going to get as many characters as we got with this first batch, because I know with the part 2 of both the Argonaut event and the Christmas event, we only got 4 characters, and I can assume that Belle is probably one of those characters, hopefully wearing like Goblin Slayer's armor, and then Sword Maiden is probably one of those characters because she is featured in the art. So it leaves 2 more slots. And because Oka and Chigusa are both here, I'm wondering that one of those slots goes to Mikoto. You also have to wonder if we're also getting like an even spread of Goblin Slayer characters, because one thing to note is that Guild Girl shares a voice actress with Lily, so they have the same voice actress there. And Amori Sensei, the author of DanMachi Light Novels, has a Twitter account, and he tweeted a picture of both Spearman and Witch. And both those characters share voice actors with DanMachi characters. Spearman being Matsuoka, who is Belle, and then Witch being Freya. So it's very interesting to see if that has anything to do with potential characters that we'll get. I also know in the PV, we see a picture with Goblin Slayer, Priestess, Belle, and Ryu. So, and Ryu is my favorite character, so I'm grasping at anything for her to get units. But it would be really cool to see Ryu get a Goblin Slayer type unit. I'm wondering what that would look like. Maybe she'd share some kind of camaraderie with High Elf Archer. But we'll just have to see what these new characters are going to be for part 2. I think Sword Maiden and Belle are pretty much guaranteed. I'd really like to see Guild Girl, especially her having interactions with both Lily and then but Aina as well, because Aina is kind of like the Guild Girl of DanMachi. And of course, this being a time-limited event, we're going to be getting heroic trials where we can get bonds to limit break the characters. Here you see Goblin Slayer and High Elf Archer pictured, so those are 2 potential bonds, and we might have another potential bond in here as well, but we'll only be able to pick one of them for this first heroic trial, Fate and Chance. And this will launch the same day as the event on the 30th. And here is the login bonus for Dungeon and Goblins that'll be going on. But the most notable thing on here are those Orario souvenirs, which will be giving us CP levels to increase on the new Goblin Slayer characters. And I'm really planning to try and get every character because for collection purposes, we don't know when we'll be getting Goblin Slayer characters back. We only got 1 rerun instance with Datalize, so we'll just have to see if we're going to get future reruns of collaboration events in the future or not. So there's no guarantee. So if you want Goblin Slayer characters, try to get them now. And of course, they're going to try and get our cold, hard-earned cash with these paid bundles. So if you have the money to spend and you want to spend it on DanMemo, go ahead. And they also teased a new Familiar Royale. This is an event, a Familia type event that we haven't had for a long time. We've been doing Familia War Games and Familia Rushes for quite a while, and it looks like they're bringing back Familia Royale in a new type of way. We don't know when that is, but it's going to be sometime during the month, the 4 weeks that this event will be active. And Record Buster will be coming back tomorrow night, and it's going to be Reveria. And as for the upcoming schedule, let's go over it pretty quickly. It's all in Japanese Standard Time, so remember, subtract a day for all these things. So on the 29th, we'll be getting the new Record Buster at Reveria. On the 30th is the launch of the collaboration event with Goblin Slayer, with the gacha, the paid bundle, the road trial, and then a bonus Iris campaign. We'll be getting 100 Iris with the launch of the event as well. And then on the 31st, we'll be getting the login bonus. That Iris combo with another item is the Hero Light bundles being reset for purchase. And then the DanMemo campaign every month. If you are a certain player rank, you'll be getting your regular 4-star single ticket. So look forward to that. So pretty exciting stuff, guys. A Goblin Slayer event. We finally got the collaboration. Really excited to see what characters are going to appear in part 2. Like I said, probably Sword Maiden and Belle, and then who knows what the other characters will be. But this is pretty exciting. I want to see what this scenario is like. How do characters interact with each other? I can't wait to see what both light novel authors have to share with us with this event. But anyway, guys, hope you are excited for the Goblin Slayer event. Hopefully you guys that were looking forward to a different collaboration aren't too disappointed. I kind of saw this coming because they are from the same light novel publisher, and then Goblin's Crown, the movie, is coming out very soon. So it all lined up pretty much, but I do think the universes will mesh together pretty well, be getting a pretty nice scenario with that. But again, if you want to see more DanMachi content, go ahead and like this video and subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Twitter and join my Discord. And as always, continue enjoying your time veggieing on audio and the dungeon. This is Lorne, your guild advisor, signing out.